Welcome back to my channel, Statistics for Applied Linguistics. I'm Dr. Marnie Menegra, and in this video today, we are going to finish off the analysis of variance with the analysis of covariance, or the ANCOVA. So what is the difference between an ANCOVA and an ANOVA? Let's have a look. So the C in ANCOVA stands for covariance, and a covariate is an independent variable that can affect the outcome of a test. It can be a possible explanatory variable of the dependent variable. However, the covariate is not the main independent variable that we're interested in. So when we're doing an ANCOVA, we're going to have an independent variable, a dependent variable, and a covariate. So here's an example. Let's say you need to look at the employees within a company, and you're going to look at gender identity and level of income. So if we were comparing the difference between the income levels and the gender, what we're really interested in is to see if the employees are paid fairly based on gender. So gender would be the independent variable. Income level would be the dependent variable. However, we may have another factor here, which is the number of years in post-secondary education. So the number of years in post-secondary education would be the covariate, because our focus for this study would be gender or gender identity. So how would we do this in JASP? First, we're going to put the data in an Excel file and then save it as a CSV file, since we need it as a CSV file to open it in JASP. Then you go to JASP, open the file. Now, the data needs to be labeled correctly. So the gender or gender identity would be the nominal category, and we would need to go in and label that male, female, and non-binary if applicable, and then go to ANOVA and click on ANCOVA. You're going to put the dependent variable in the dependent variable box, which is going to be the income, and independent variable in the fixed factors box, which will be the gender, and covariate in the covariate box, which would be years of post-secondary education. Then we can click on the effect size and get our eta squared for the ANCOVA. We can look at the descriptives and get the descriptive plots. You can also choose a post hoc test and select the confidence intervals, and then you will analyze the results. So let's see what this will look like on the slides, and then we will go live into JASP. Okay, so let's say I have JASP open, and I'm going to open up the ANCOVA CSV file. Then once this is open, gender, we've switched this to nominal here, and then we need to add the labels, because originally they were just labeled as 1 and 2. So we're going to change the numerical values to male versus female, and for both income and education in years, these do need to be scale. So we need to change that to scale. Now we're going to go to ANOVA and click on ANCOVA. Once we've clicked on ANCOVA, from the box on the left, we're going to drag income over to the dependent variable, gender over to the fixed factors, and covariates will be the education in years. Now we can scroll down a little and click on the descriptive statistics and the estimates of effect size, which we could get the eta squared here. So if we look at gender up in the contingency table, we know that it's significant with a high effect size, and the education in years, this is also significant with a very high effect size. We've got a descriptive mean and standard deviation here, and then we can go to descriptive plots. I've put education in years in the horizontal axis and the gender as separate lines. So the income would be on the y-axis, and the education in years along the x-axis. We've got two different lines here for gender or gender identity. Now we can get a post hoc test. We scroll down a little further. We will click on standard, on 2-key, and the confidence interval at 95%. So I can see here that with the lower to the upper, it does not cross 0, which means that this is significant. And so the gender or gender identity within this company does play a huge difference in, or does play a difference in the rate of income or the amount of income that is paid to these employees. Okay, so to analyze the ANCOVA results, there is a difference in income between the two genders, which is significant with a large effect size. Additionally, the number of years of post-secondary education plays a role, and this is also significant with a very large effect size. Okay, now let's go live into JASP. I'm going to stop sharing this screen here and we'll open up JASP. And with JASP, I'm going to open up my file, and the ANCOVA example is a CSV. This is now open. So for gender, I'm going to first click on number one here, and we're going to change this to male, and we'll change this to female. If I had a third category, I could change this to non-binary. We're going to switch and make sure that we've got the labels down here, which is good. And then we're going to change education in years to scale. Okay, so this looks good here. Now we will go to ANOVA and click on ANCOVA. So gender identity we know is our fixed factor. Income will go into dependent and education in years as covariate. And so we've got our contingency table here. We're missing the effect size though. So we can click on the eta squared here and we can see the high effect size for gender, very high effect size for education in years. We can also click on the descriptive statistics to get the mean and standard deviation if this is of interest. And then we can scroll down here and we can get our descriptive plots. So for the descriptive plots, I'm going to put gender as separate lines and education in years as separate plots. When you get the graph like this, you can actually just stretch that out and it will reformat so it looks a little bit nicer here. And then let's go get our post hoc test. So for our post hoc test, we're going to move gender over. We've got Tukey and standard here, and we can display the confidence intervals. And here we go. It does not cross zero, so we know that there is a significant difference in pay or income within this company between males and females. Now, this is data that I had just made up, so this is not an actual company or a real situation, but this is just an example for you here. So this comes to the end of the video for the ANCOVA. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.